Hello, Mr. R. Nijab, a retired lecturer of metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I am doing Matthew 5, Beautitudes, or Sermon on the Mount. So I did the previous video, blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Saint James the Just was a peacemaker in Jerusalem. And he used to kneel down the person who had cheated another person. He will go to the aggressor, kneel down, and beg him to return his money to do justice. So he will get it done because they had some conscience. But in India, no conscience. They have very bad. They were kings and emperors of darkness. So the next is, you know, Matthew 5:10, blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the royal kingdom of God, and not the kingdom of heaven as written in the Bible. Kingdom of heaven is different from the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is within your heart, whereas the kingdom of heaven is outside, that you see in law and order. As Peter was given the key to the kingdom of heaven, if people speak the truth and obey what the rabbi tells them to do, 10 commandments, then you will see the outside in the public, there will be peace like heaven. So that is the kingdom of heaven is outside. Royal kingdom of God is inside your heart, is in your heart, not outside. So blessed are those who are persecuted, because a person who is a righteous person, you know, he does not get his say heard. People who are liars and who are a crook, you know, who can bribe or who can push their way through, they will be heard. And you being righteous, you don't want to bribe anyone. You don't want to say, take favor of anyone. Because if you take favor, then the person who does the favor or who changes the course of righteousness, he becomes a son of Satan or a bastard worse than those born of the prostitutes. I will explain in the next one how in the boundary issue, the ombudsman came to visit my house to see the situation. So I told him I preach Christianity, and in Jesus you have to be righteous, not doing favor to me or to the neighbor. So when you do your assessment or when you write your report, be righteous. If you are not righteous, then you become a son of Satan, which are bastards, worse than those born of the prostitutes. And then he said, oh, you are very harsh, you know. And when he finished and wrote his report, he did favor to the neighbor. He accepted the wrong demarcation by the surveyor, which I refuted, and the council had accepted it, so he too accepted it without any reason. I told him if he can't read the drawing, I can help him. He said, no, he knows how to read it. So such is the thing, that you get persecuted by these people. And we stand on our righteousness. We don't want to be unrighteous. So the people who are righteous, they suffer. And they suffer because the other people are crook, bribe, and other influence. Some are Freemasons and this and that. They have their own favors. So when people do favor to somebody, then they become son of Satan, or they become bastards, worse than those born of the prostitutes. But most of them, they don't know. They just do the favor. Oh, this man is a Freemason, I am a Freemason, so let me do the favor, nobody will be able to challenge me. That I will come in the next videos. So the kingdom of heaven is outside, and royal kingdom of God is within your heart. It is in this heart that Christ Jesus enters, and when he enters, then you are blessed with Christ with small c. Christ Jesus is Christ with capital C, because he has the Holy Spirit with capital S. And when we are being human being, our spirit is spirit of men, not of God. Spirit of God, you receive it by the grace of God, as the 12 laborers or workers of Christ Jesus were paid their wage at Pentecost. Then they got Holy Spirit with the capital S. And Peter was the one who was most drunk, because he was once born. From once born, he became thrice born. So blessed are you when people insult you. Now people, you know, when I go to churches and I preach Christianity and tell them that how can you serve God when you are paid in mammon. So you are serving mammon, you are speaking the gospel of mammon and not of God. Gospel of mammon is sugar-coated tablets of falsehoods. And then they are not happy. They put on this dog collar, and if you ask them what you do for your living, we do nothing. We are here. The laborer is worth his keep. And that's how they ask you. So common sense prevailing, if a person is paid in mammon, then he works for mammon and not for God. If you work for God, then God will pay you in gospel truth, as it was he was paying Saint Paul, who worked as a tent maker. He did not live on the charity of the people. So these people who live on the charity of widows' mite, they are worse than those temple priests which shouted at Christ Jesus and wanted to throw him out. So you too, if you preach gospel, you too will be thrown out of the churches, because you don't agree with them. You are not a mammon worshipper, you are God worshipper. You are God orientated. So if you are God orientated, do not accept any mammon in exchange for preaching gospel or visiting churches. So spend your own money to visit the church, and then if you have to eat, try to find your own food. To the most, you can take a cup of tea or something, you know, out of their gratitude if the people are appreciating. If the people are not appreciating, even you should not take anything from them and shake their the dust of that house very much. And those who look after you, who treat you in the name of Jesus, bless those houses. God, they are the one who are sealed to serve God. Those who are not sealed to serve God, they will not entertain you. So there are very few people who are truth-loving. Most of the people, they want to hear sugar-coated tablets of falsehood. And when they hear these things, they become fanatic. And fanatic create wars. So no wonder, you know, people who are sensible, they have shunned the religion altogether, and they become atheist and humanist, which are these people who are clean-hearted, but they reject the hypocrisy. God bless you.